well, good evening. Congratulations, first of all. It's always nice, I guess, to be recognised, particularly for a body of work. The first question I wanted to ask you, because obviously there'll be a lot of writers watching this. Am I right in thinking, and I got this from Wikipedia, so let me know. But it apparently,
right.
Before you sold your first script, you actually had 37 no's. Is that true? Something like that?
No, and 67 on The Bodyguard.
Really?
The Bodyguard was the first script I ever sold, and it wasn't made for about 14 years, but 67, and I have a list from my agent at that time. He had kept index cards of every rejection, and so it's all proof there.
Wow. It proves that nobody knows anything.
Nobody knows anything, and you have to stick in there, stay with it, you know.
So, that was going to be my follow-up question. Mm-hmm. So presumably persistence is really, you know, the key here.
It really is. And Frank Pearson, wonderful screenwriter and director, and when I was trying to get into the business, I saw an interview with him, and he had been a Life magazine reporter, but he always wanted to make movies. And he said the only people doing it are the ones that didn't quit. And that had an enormous impact on me, because it's very tempting to quit. It's hard to do the work, it's hard to get a break, it's hard to sell something. So it's very tempting to say, screw it.
And of course, you know, you've had some enormous successes, but there was that kind of the twin whammy almost of, you know, after you got to know Steven Spielberg and then George Lucas, that kind of twin whammy of, you know, working on both Star Wars and Indiana Jones in quite rapid succession.
Yeah, hey, Raiders first.
Yeah. You wrote Raiders first?
When I sold... The second script I sold was to Steven. It was called Continental Divide. And I went out to meet him. I had never met him. And he said, George and I are going to do an adventure movie, and we don't know much about it, but I want you to go with me to see George and talk about doing it. Because they had liked... In Continental Divide, there's a lot of sort of screwball dialogue between the guy and the girl.
That's the, John Belushi and Blair Brown?
Yes, that's right. Yeah. And directed by Michael Apted. And this was long before that happened, and they just liked the way the man and the woman talked to each other in the script. And they said, that's what we want for this adventure movie we're going to do. And I said, great. And, you know, George had just made Star Wars, and... Yeah. Steven had just made Close Encounters.
Wow.
So to be involved with them was very exciting. I had been trying to get into this business for 7 years, and a month before I was working in advertising. So then you want to go make up a story with George and Steven.
Wow. So, and of course, both of those films, absolutely cemented in kind of pop culture forevermore. So that's, that must be... an incredible feeling, because every writer wants, you know, acknowledgement, but you can't really get it on a bigger scale than you had there.
No, it was very good. And I had, the thing it did for me that was amazing was that 3 years after I sold my first screenplay, I was directing, which is was the whole purpose of the writing to begin with.
Yeah.
And so it happened very rapidly.
Yeah.
So I sold a couple scripts. I wrote Raiders. I wrote Empire, and I was directing Body Heat. 3 years later.
Well, again, on the directing side, you've had some phenomenal successes. I guess a lot of writers would be curious, with their own aspirations to not only sell scripts but perhaps to make their own.
Yeah.
What does a writer bring as a director, and also what does a writer have to learn rapidly as a director?
Yeah. I once said to George when I was about to direct Body Heat, I said, you know, I'm totally excited that this couldn't have gone any better, but there are a lot of technical things I don't know. And George said, directing movies has absolutely nothing to do with technical things.
Right.
He said, it's all about what kind of person you are. And I've never seen that disproved in anything I've seen. And you can see very good movies that are made by people, you can see that you would hate the person. And you see bad movies, you say, well, that might be a decent guy, but I don't like his movies.
Yeah, yeah.
And then what you're hoping for is you see a movie and you say, my God, I'd like to meet that person because their view of the world is so interesting and so wide-ranging.
Yeah. So, of course, now, you know, the world, the internet and the world in general is abuzz with your forthcoming projects. One thing I was curious about is the world has changed in that writing a script used to be kind of a private process.
Yes.
And now the level of speculation before presumably, you know, pen hits paper. I mean, how are you finding it very different just the this time around being involved in the Star Wars universe?
It's exciting, but you have to remember that when I was writing Raiders, no one knew anything about Indiana Jones. But when I handed it in and George said, I'm in trouble on The Empire Strikes Back, I was getting on the biggest franchise, the biggest sequel that had ever been.
Yeah.
This was the biggest movie ever. And it started right then, and that was in 1977. So I've had a lot of experience with highly anticipated things, and you hope that people are happy with what comes out.
Well, I wonder if in some ways that makes you almost, with this new incarnation that's coming through Disney, it's almost like you're the Yoda of the universe. You're protecting the...
More and more like him. That's what's so disturbing. You do hope. You hope that you're if you liked the first trilogy, you're hoping that you're protecting those elements that maybe have gotten lost.
When did, obviously we all only found out about it recently, when did word get to you from George or whoever contacted you to say, hey, what do you think about getting involved again?
Last fall, fall of 2012, I went up to see George and Kathy, and I've known them both for 35 years. Kathy was Steven's assistant when I was writing Raiders in Steven's office. I had no office. And I said, I don't have anywhere to write. And Steven said, well, I'm directing 1941. I'm barely in my office. Why don't you use my desk?
Okay.
And it was pretty heady stuff for someone who'd been in advertising a month earlier.
Wow.
And who'd been trying to get into movies for 7 years. So, and Kathy was around all the time. And now we've been working together now, and it's quite, we've been friends the entire time. We both have houses in Colorado, and to be working with her again in this capacity, and she's taken over Lucasfilm with amazing authority, it's very satisfying, you know.
I guess when you're working with people you've known so long, yeah, that probably helps you kind of fall into a groove relatively quickly, I would think.
Yeah, although as a writer, you almost never fall into a groove. You're hoping to fall into a groove. But what you do fall into a groove of communication. And the fun part, and after the meeting with George and Kathy, who I know very well, eventually it... And I met Simon Kinberg and Michael Arndt, lovely guys. I'd never really worked with writers that way, you know. I'd had a lot of collaborators, but never in a writer's room, sort of. And then when JJ came in, not only was it exciting in terms of now we can move forward with the movie, but he is a lovely, funny, energetic guy.
Yeah, well, that's good.
So, yeah.
So the process so far is... looking good.
It's like a lot of things in my life, very lucky.
I wondered if you could maybe clear up a little bit of the kind of the noise, just in as much as first we heard they're making a new Star Wars, they're making a trilogy, they're making 10, they're making spin-offs, they're making non-canon films about individual characters. Now, all we actually know for a fact is that you are involved, there are going to be potentially a number of films. Could you maybe steer us with give us a little clarity on what you're allowed to tell us of what's actually going on and your part in it?
You've described it perfectly.
Do you think you're going to be doing a lot of interviews over the next year where you have to be this cagey?
I've done a lot tonight.
Well, I just want to congratulate you. Hope you have a great evening.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Cheers. Thank you.